Accepted himself as my subordinate by marrying my daughter in the presence of fire and brahmanas. He has married my daughter, who is equal to Gayatri, and has pretended to be just like an honest person.
Even, 他通过当着brahmana的面，在火面前娶了我的女儿，接受我为他的长辈。
Daksha's statement that Lord Shiva pretended to be an honest person means that Shiva was dishonest, because in spite of accepting the position of Daksha's son-in-law, he was not respectful to Daksha.
药指由师的泡泡提供 Daksha说 主Shiva装得像个诚实的人， 意思是说主Shiva并不诚实， 因为他虽然当了Daksha的女婿， 却不尊重Daksha。
Omagyanatimarandasya
Gyanatimarandasya Chasurulihariyena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manovi
we're hearing about conflict between Daksha and Lord Shiva.
我们在《国家法坛》当中听聆听到，在主 Shiva 和 Daksha 之间的争执。
Now Daksha was Daksha had an important position in the universe as a Prajapati. He was meant to produce beings to help to populate the universe.
Daksha 在宇宙创造当中，他的地位是 Prajapati， 他是为了在宇宙之中，他来繁衍后代，让宇宙中充满人口。
The word Daksha means one who is expert.
Daksha 这个意思是一个很精通的人。
So Daksha was expert in producing children.
所以 Daksha 他擅长于生产人口，繁衍人口。
And he had some daughters, and one of the daughters happened to be Sati, who became the wife of Lord Shiva.
他有许多女儿，有一个女儿是 Sati， 她成为了主 Shiva 的，她成为了主 Shiva 的妻子。
Now, Lord Shiva also has a very important position, very important role in the universal administration.
主 Shiva 在宇宙管理当中也占据了重要的地位。
He is in charge. He is in charge of the mode of ignorance, and he is responsible for the work of destroying the universe at the time of annihilation.
他负责掌管着愚昧属性，他负责在宇宙毁灭的时候，毁灭整个宇宙。
And he has a very intimate relationship with the Supreme Lord Vishnu.
他跟至尊主 Vishnu 有亲密的关系。
And sometimes we see the deities which are a combination of Vishnu and Shiva.
有的时候我们看见有的神像是 Vishnu 和 Shiva， 他们俩合在一起。
There's one deity, there's one place in Mayapur, when we go on Navadvipdham Parikram, there's a temple there of Harihar. Harihar. Hari means Lord Vishnu, and Har means Lord Shiva.
我们在 Navadvip Parikram 的时候呢，有一个庙，它就是那个庙的主神叫 Harihar. Hari 是主 Vishnu, Hara 是主 Shiva.
And the two one half of the deity is Vishnu, one half of the deity is Shiva.
这神像有一半是 Vishnu， 有一半是 Shiva.
You see, in one hand, Lord Vishnu is holding his Sudarshan Chakra, and on the other side, you see Lord Shiva. He's holding his Trishu, the three-pronged fork.
这个神像呢，它的 Vishnu 那一半呢是拿着 Sudarshan Chakra 神碟，那么另外一半是拿着三叉戟 Shiva 的武器。
One half of the deity is black for Vishnu, and the other half is white for Lord Shiva.
有这个神像一半是黑色的，是 Vishnu， 另外一半是 Shiva， 白色。
It's not that Lord Shiva is exactly equal to Vishnu, but he has a very intimate relationship with Lord Vishnu.
并不是说主 Shiva 跟主 Vishnu 一模一样，但是因为主 Shiva 跟主 Vishnu 有亲密的关系。
So they're so close to each other that Lord Vishnu has that, accepts him like that on an equal relationship.
因为他们的关系这么亲密，所以主 Vishnu 就接受他，跟他的地位一样。
Now, Daksha became proud of the fact that his daughter was married to Lord Shiva.
现在 Daksha 他感到非常的骄傲，因为他的女儿已经嫁给了主 Shiva.
And he thought that Lord Shiva should worship him.
他就认为 主 Shiva 应该崇拜他这个岳父。
But Lord Shiva always meditates. He's always engaged in the worship of the Supreme Lord Vishnu.
可是主 Shiva 在内心总是冥想着至尊主 Vishnu.
That Lord Vishnu is Lord Shiva is known as the greatest Vaishnava.
主 Shiva 以伟大的 Vaishnava 著称。
Because he's always his mind is always fixed on the lotus feet of the Lord.
他的心意恒常专注于 Vishnu 的莲花足。
So Daksha was not able to appreciate this activity of Lord Shiva. And he began to become offensive to Lord Shiva. And began to criticize him. Just like here we read, he's accusing Lord Shiva of not being honest.
He's
saying because he accepted my daughter, it means he should be, he's under me, he's under my authority. He should be bowing to me, he should be worshipping me. But Lord Shiva is always worshipping the Supreme Lord. So Daksha is beginning to become very offensive, to commit offenses against Lord Shiva. So this is the mad elephant offense. The first offense in chanting the holy name. When we blaspheme a devotee who has dedicated the life to the worship of the Lord. So Daksha will get very serious, he'll be punished for his offenses. This will be described later on, and as we go on, we will hear more how Daksha is punished for behaving like this. We see examples of other devotees, other great people who also offended a devotee, how they also got in trouble. They also got havoc in their life. Just like Ambarish Maharaj was a great devotee and he was offended by Durvasa Muni.
Ambarish Maharaj Da Jin is a great devotee. He was Durvasa Muni.
Durvasa Muni was proud of his position. He was a great yogi, he was a sannyasi, he was a guru with many disciples.
Durvasa Muni, he felt proud of his position.
So he was so proud that he thought he became envious of Maharaj Ambarish. Ambarish Maharaj was loved by all of his citizens. He was the ruler of the kingdom and he was loved by all of the citizens. And Durvasa Muni could not understand why Maharaj Ambarish should be so popular. And so Durvasa Muni made a plan to give trouble to Maharaj
Ambarish.
Durvasa Muni tried to find a fault with Maharaj Ambarish when he was actually without any fault. Durvasa Muni said that Maharaj Ambarish had broken a fast before giving food to him, to Durvasa Muni.
Broke
his fast. He should have fed me first and then broke fast. When the guest comes, then even if you're the king, it's the duty to serve food to the guests.
那么当有来客的时候呢，虽然
Just like we see Lord Krishna, when Sudama Brahman came to visit Dwarka, Lord Krishna received Sudama so nicely. He fed him, washed his feet, fed him. And similarly, Rukmini also, Queen Rukmini, before she married Krishna, she sent a brahmana to Dwarka with a letter to give to Krishna.
Dwarka said, Rukmini, 她在嫁给Krishna之前, 她给Krishna, 她派一个婆罗门给Krishna送去一封信。
So the Vaishnava etiquette is like that, that the guest comes, they should be fed first.
这就是Vaishnava的礼仪,当有客人来的时候,应该首先款待客人。
Especially when the guest is some sannyasi or a brahmana.
特别是当来客是一位托钵僧或者是一位婆罗门。
So, Durvasa was upset that Maharaj Ambarish drank water. He took a glass of water before feeding him.
Durvasa Muni, 就因为Ambarish大君在给他款待他吃饭之前呢，自己先喝了一杯水，他就生气了。
Durvasa Muni tried to kill Maharaj. But Krishna, of course, protected Maharaj Ambarish.
Krishna, he protected Ambarish.
And Durvasa Muni had to run to save his life. He ran everywhere.
Durvasa Muni, he wanted to escape. He was in the world, up and down, running.
He went to see Lord Brahma and he asked Lord Brahma to help him.
He went to the Brahmaic宫. He asked the Brahmaic宫.
But Lord Brahma could not help him, so he went to see Lord Shiva and he begged for help from Lord Shiva. And Lord Shiva also could not help him. So then he went to Lord Narayan in Vaikuntha. And Lord Narayan said, I also can't help. Because you have offended my devotee. You have to go to the devotee to get
forgiveness.
And so Durvasa Muni came back and fell at the feet of Maharaj Ambarish. Now, Maharaj Ambarish, of course, immediately said, oh, I don't find any fault with you, and please don't bow to me. So Maharaj Ambarish immediately accepted Durvasa Muni.
Ambarish 大君呢立刻就跟他说，在我眼里你没有什么缺点，不用向我顶拜。他立刻就接受了Durvasa Muni。
So here we have Daksha and Lord Shiva, and Daksha is being very offensive. Talking bad, nasty, very bad things about Lord Shiva.
那在这里呢，Daksha他就冒犯了主Shiva，他对主Shiva非常刻薄的言语。Now
sometimes these family things, the family situation is difficult. You get married, sometimes there's problem between the in-laws.
在婚姻生活当中呢，有时候就在亲属之间会有一些问题。
Girl goes to stay in the husband's home, she may not be able to get along very well with the mother of her husband.
新婚的妻子去了丈夫家，她跟婆婆就处不好婆媳关系。So
here it's the father-in-law and the husband.
那在这里呢，是岳父和女婿之间的关系，处在紧张的状态下。
So Daksha is offensive, and this is worse than simply being attached to sense gratification.
那这里的 Daksha 他对主西文冒犯，这比感官享乐还要严重。
Ajamila was a sinful person.
Ajamila 是一个罪人。
But he was never offensive.
但是 Ajamila 他从来没有做冒犯。
So when he chanted the holy name, even though he was chanting the name without knowing he was chanting the holy name, he got benefit.
Ajamila 他唱诵圣名，虽然他并不知道唱诵圣名的荣耀，但他得到了好处。
He got the benefit of chanting the holy name in this intermediate stage, what we call the shadow stage, the shadow of the pure name.
他唱诵圣名的是处在中间的阶段，叫 shadow 影子唱诵圣名影子衣服的阶段。
There are three stages in chanting.
唱诵圣名分为三个阶段。
Right, the first stage is called offensive chant.
第一个阶段叫冒犯阶段，冒犯。
We were saying the ten offenses this morning.
我们今天早上呢，一起背诵了唱诵圣名十诫。
So Lord Shiva at Radhadaksha is breaking, he's committing the first offense.
Daksha, 他就做出了第一条冒犯。
Offending a devotee, a great devotee.
他冒犯奉献者，冒犯伟大奉献者。
So because he is offensive to a devotee, so it brings disaster on him.
他冒犯伟大奉献者，就产生了灾难性的后果。
So devotees, as devotees, we are always very careful not to offend a devotee.
身为奉献者，我们应该小心翼翼，不要冒犯另一位奉献者。
We have to. How can we avoid offending devotees? We can avoid offending them by praising them.
我们怎么才能避免冒犯奉献者呢？我们可以通过赞扬、赞美奉献者来避免冒犯奉献者。
Instead of seeing the faults in the devotees, we want to see the good qualities.
我们不应该看奉献者的缺点，我们应该看到奉献者的优点、长处。
We want to see our own faults and the good qualities in others.
我们要看到自己身上的缺点和短处。看到别的奉献者身上的长处和优点。
It's not good for us to look at the faults in other people.
只是挑别人的毛病，看别人的缺点，对我们没有好处。
Of course, if we see the faults in others, then we should be careful that we don't commit the same faults.
当然，如果我们看到别人身上确实有缺点的时候呢，我们要确保自己不要有同样的缺点。
We shouldn't try to just give instructions to others.
我们不应该一味的只是挑别人的毛病来，喜欢当别人的老师，给别人教导。
We just simply want to show a good example ourselves.
我们应该自己以身作则，做出表率。
No, we say that showing the good example is better than giving instructions.
那有一句谚语就是说。自己做出表率比给别人教导要好。
If we give instructions to other people, they may take offense. They may not like it.
如果我们只是给别人教导、指导的话，他们会觉得受到了冒犯，内心会有被得罪的感觉。
They may say, "Why are you telling me what to do?"
他们会想，你为什么要对我指手画脚呢？
They may say, "You're not my authority."
他们会说你不是我的权威。
You have no right to tell me what to do.
你没有权利告诉我你应该怎么去做。
So therefore, we can avoid that situation if we just simply show a good example.
如果我们自己做出以身作则，做出表率的话，就能避免产生这样的结果。
But if we try to become the authority, we try to give instructions to others.Then they may not accept us as their teacher.
如果我们只是把自己处在一个权威的地位上给别人教导的话，别人并不会接受我们的这样的教导和地位。
Right. If we're not their teacher, then we don't have any right to instruct them.
如果我们自己不是老师的话，我们没有权利给别人教导。
So Daksha should have understood. See, Daksha's unfortunate that he's become bewildered because Lord Shiva married his daughter.
由于主 Shiva 他娶了 Daksha 的女儿， Daksha 就为这个事实就感到迷惑了。
So Daksha was thinking that because he's married his daughter, Lord Shiva is his subordinate.
Daksha 认为因为主 Shiva 娶了他的女儿，所以主 Shiva 就处在他的地位之下，应该是从属于他。
He does not understand the position of Lord Shiva.
他不明白主 Shiva 的崇高地位。
The Lord Shiva is he's God. We said he's God in the material world.
那我们说主 Shiva 是物质世界的神。
And he's worshipped by many people.
他受到很多人。众多生物的崇拜。
Even Sanatana Goswami, one of the six Goswamis of Vrindavan, Sanatana Goswami is a great devotee of Lord Shiva.
Vrindavan 的 Sanatana Goswami 也是主 Shiva 的伟大奉献者。
By the worship, by the mercy of Lord Shiva, then we can get Krishna consciousness.
由于主 Shiva 的仁慈，我们可以获得 Krishna 知觉。
Because Lord Shiva can take away our false ego.
因为主 Shiva 可以拿走我们的假自我。
Lord Shiva has that kind of power.
主 Shiva 有这样的能力。
He is a very compassionate soul.
主 Shiva 他心怀怜悯。
He gives his association to people who are in the mood.Ignorance.
他给那些处在愚昧属性的人 给予他们他自己的怜悯。
Because he gives so much mercy to people in the mode of ignorance, sometimes he also becomes a thing.
由于他给这些愚昧属性的人那么多的怜悯和仁慈以及怜悯，他自己有时候会受到影响。
Bad association.He associates with fallen people, with people in poor consciousness, then after some time it will also affect us. So we also have to be careful not to be too much affected by bad association.
We also have to be careful not to be不要由于不良的联谊受到这些不良联谊的影响。
Lord Shiva has the power to be able to drink the poison. When the demigods and the demons churned the ocean of milk, they produced some poison, and Lord Shiva drank that poison.
主 Shiva 有能力喝下一汪洋毒液，当半神和恶魔搅拌甘露之海的时候。产生的毒液就被主 Shiva 喝掉了。
So this was the compassion of Lord Shiva. He was so kind.
主 Shiva 他是非常有怜悯之情的。
And when he drank that poison, his throat went blue. So he's got the name Nilakanta.
主 Shiva 他喝下一汪洋毒液的时候，他的喉咙就变蓝，就变成了蓝色，所以他有一个名叫 Nila。
Just like when you drink some poison, then you know that will affect the color of the skin.
就如果一个人他喝了毒药的话呢，他的皮肤就会变色。
Or you have some infection, then the skin will be affected, will dark color.
就是如或者说一个人当时他受到感染的时候呢，他会得皮肤病。
Lord Shiva drank the poison, and his throat went blue.And naturally, because he drank poison, then his bodily temperature increased. It became very hot.
主 Shiva 他喝完毒药之后呢，他的体温就升上去了。
Right, you drink some poison stuff that increases the fire in the body. You become like in a fever.
那一个人他喝了毒药之后呢，他的体温上升，那这时候他会有发烧的感觉。
So to keep Lord Shiva cool, he was given the crescent moon. You can see the crescent moon on his head.
所以为了让主师把他的体温降下去呢，他就被给予月亮新月。你可以看到主师把他的头上顶着一轮新月。
The moon is very cooling.
这个新月它是非常有清凉的效果。
In the night, when the sun goes down, the moon comes up. It's very cooling.
当夜晚的时候呢，太日落，然后月亮升起的时候，这时候很清凉。
So Lord Shiva has that crescent moon on his head.
主 Shiva 他头上就顶着这轮新月。
So Lord Shiva is so kind to people. He gives so much mercy.
主 Shiva 他对众生是非常怜悯的。
But still, people like Daksha find fault with him.
但是，即便主 Shiva 是这么有怜悯之心，像 Daksha 这样的人物也会从他身上挑毛病。
Just like Srila Prabhupada did so much preaching, but still some people would find fault with him.
就像我们的 Srila Prabhupada, 他做了这么多传教工作，仍然会有人挑他的毛病。
Some people said, "Oh, he has ruined the Hindu culture."
有的人就说 Srila Prabhupada, 他毁坏了这个印度的文化。
He has given our culture to so many malechas.So many low-class people.
他们就认为是他把印度文化给了那些 Malaysia 那些低等的出生的人。
And sometimes the people also in Jagannath Puri, the pundits in Jagannath Puri, they also criticize Prabhupada.
在 Jagannath Puri 那些 pundits 那些学者，他们也批评是他。
They say because.Rath Yatra is supposed to be held on one particular day in the year.
他们说这个盘车节呢，只是应该在一年当中的特定日子举行。
It's a specific date on the lunar calendar, not in the solar calendar.
是按照阴历的计算，是在特定的日期举行盘车节。
And so every year in Jagannath Puri, they have the Rath Yatra on that particular day.
每一年在扎格纳的普瑞就在这个特定的日子来举行盘车节。
So also in many of the temples in India, we also have Rath Yatra the same day.
在印度，我们也会在很多城市同一个日期举行盘车节。
But outside India, we don't follow that.
但是在印度之外，我们不遵守这个日期。
You know, we wouldn't be able to have a Rath Yatra here in Bangkok on any other day except a Sunday.
我们在这曼谷就除了星期天，然后我们其他时候就不举行盘车节。
And many other cities in the Western countries where they have Rath Yatra, they will only hold Rath Yatra on a Sunday.
在西方的很多国家呢，他们也只挑在星期日来举办盘车节。
Because Sunday is the day when the shops are not so busy, things are a bit more peaceful, and people are not working, it's easier for them to take part.
因为在星期天周末呢，商店呢，就他们都不营业，而且人们也不上班，他们有时间。
But, and so for the sake of preaching, Prabhupada said, yeah, whenever you like, you can put on the Rath Yatra, whenever it's convenient.
所以呢，为了传教的目的呢，施德帕帕德他们就是可以在方便的日期举办盘车节。
But the pundits in Jagannath Puri, they're very angry. They hate the Krishna movement because we popularize Rath Yatra. We have Rath Yatra any day we like.
但是在加拿大的普瑞的那些潘尼的学者们，他们就批评 Krishna 这些运动。他们就憎恨就是这个运动被这个原因。
And when we go to Malaysia, we'll be there on the particular day when they have Rath Yatra in India.
在马来西亚的时候，我们就会在特定的在印度举办盘车节的日期，刚好赶在这个日期来赶上盘车节。
And we will have Rath Yatra there in Malaysia that day.
我们在马来西亚的时候就恰好。放在这个恰当的日期赶上盘车节。
Which is the actual day when they have it in India and many places.
就是在印度举办盘车节的同一天，我们在马来西亚参加盘车节。
Like in Chennai, the Rath Yatra in Chennai, they always have it in January.
在印度钦奈这个城市，他们一般是在一月份，举办禅车节。
It's a convenient time for them in South India. So different places they do it at different times of the year.
是在不同地方呢，他们是在一年当中的不同日期举办节日。
But Prabhupada did not worry about having it on the on any particular day. He just liked us to have a nice festival.
但是帕帕德对于这个日期并不是很关注，他只是希望人们举办一个很欢庆的典礼。
So people criticize. Some people criticize him for this.
因为这个原因就他就遭到有的人的批评。
It's very hard to please everyone.
要想让每一个人的高兴是非常难的。
We cannot expect that we'll ever please everyone.
我们不要指望我们能让每一个人都感到高兴。
We have to try to. Our purpose is to try to please Krishna.
我们的目标应该是努力的取悦 Krishna.
Well, Krishna is pleased wherever the devotees are chanting the holy name.
无论在哪里，奉献者们唱诵他的圣名 ，Krishna 就高兴。
Krishna is pleased when he sees the devotees glorify Lord Jagannath. And when he sees people have a nice festival, offer a lot of prasadam, distribute a lot of prasadam, then Krishna is pleased.
When Krishna sees people have a nice festival, offer a lot of prasadam, distribute a lot of prasadam,
Krishna won't say, oh, you can't do Rath Yatra that day, you have to do it this day.
Krishna 不会说你不应该在那一天举办节日，你只应该在这一天举办节日。
Sometimes also people criticize Prabhupada that he worship Radha and Krishna without having Ganges water.
有的人也批评是的 Prabhupada 没有恒河水就来崇拜 Radha Krishna。
But Prabhupada just did everything according to the time and the place and the circumstances.
是的，帕帕他是按照时间、地点、场合来做事情。
He didn't worry about all the little rules and regulations.
他并不是关注那些细微的细节、规范原则。
The most important thing is to remember Krishna.
重要的是永远记住 Krishna.
So if something helps us to remember Krishna, then that is a success. That's important. It doesn't matter when or how you do it.
所以如果有的事情能让我们帮助我们记忆 Krishna, 这是最重要的，而不是我们在什么时间做事情，怎么去做。
So Lord,Daksha has not understood all of this, and therefore he's criticizing Lord Shiva.
Daksha 不明白这一点，因此他批评 Shiva.
So you see, we can see how easy it is to become influenced by the material energy.
我们看到呢，要受到物质能量的影响是多么轻而易举。
Even though Daksha has a big position, he's an important man in the universe, and he's respected by many people, but he has no right to offend Lord Shiva.
虽然 Daksha 在宇宙当中占据了非常重要的地位，而且得到很多人的尊重和崇拜，但是他没有权利冒犯主 Shiva.
In the material world, it happens that when people get a bigger position, they become more and more proud.
在物质世界，当一个人他的地位爬得越来越高的时候，他就会越来越骄傲。
But in spiritual consciousness, the one person who becomes more advanced and high, he becomes more humble.
但是在 Krishna 世界当中，当一个人他越进步，他就越来越谦卑。
Our advancement is understood by how much we've developed humility.
我们的进步程度取决于你在多大程度上培养了谦卑。
Humility comes about by seeing our own faults and appreciating others.
当我们看到自己身上的缺点，看到别人身上的优点和长处，就会发展我们的谦卑。
When devotees would write to Prabhupada, glorifying devotees and appreciating all the activities of devotees, Prabhupada would feel very happy.
当奉献者们给舒达帕帕写信，荣耀其他奉献者所做的服务的时候，帕帕感到非常的喜悦。He
said, I can tell you are making nice advancements.
他就回信说，我从你的信中呢，可以看出你已经取得了长足的进步。
But when people would write to Prabhupada complaining and finding fault with devotees, then Prabhupada would feel very disappointed.
但是当有的奉献者给舒达帕帕写信，抱怨并且是指责别的奉献的时候，帕帕感到非常的失望。
Prabhupada said, "This is a material disease."
帕帕说这是一个物质的疾病。
Yeah, they become fault finding. We see faults. We see only the faults in others. We don't see the good.
它是物质的疾病，就是我们只是看到别人身上的错误，我们没有看到别人身上的好处、优点。
So Prabhupada wanted that we would develop the nice consciousness to appreciate, to work together with the devotees.
是的，爸爸希望我们发展出优秀的知觉来彼此的合作。
When Prabhupada first came to India after being in America, first Prabhupada went to America and began the movement there and recruited some devotees. Then he came back to India.
是的，爸爸他首先去了美国，在那里发展慧生的知觉。他接受了一些门徒之后，他回到印度。
So he brought some of the senior men with him to India.
他带了一些年长资深的门徒跟他一起去印度。
But because these men had all been leaders in different cities, when they all came together, it was difficult for them to work together.
因为这些年长奉献者他们是不同城市的领导，当他们在一起的时候，他们合作就有些困难。
So Prabhupada saw how the different devotees were all having trouble to get along with each other.
是的，帕帕看到这些年长的资深的奉献者，他们彼此合作有一些困难，有麻烦。
So Prabhupada instituted here, every morning after the Mangal Aarti, everyone must offer obeisances to each other.
帕帕就制定了一个制度，就在Mangal Aarti，就是早上的Aarti之后呢，每一个奉献者都要向其他的奉献者顶拜。
He said, this will help us to remove any offenses we may have committed against another devotee.
他说这向其他奉献者顶拜，就能帮助我们，能够消除我们对其他奉献者做出的冒犯。
Because offenses against a devotee can delay and can stop our progress, any progress in Krishna consciousness.
因为对其他奉献者的冒犯会阻止、延迟我们在 Krishna 知觉的进步。
So what does it mean to offend a devotee?
冒犯奉献者是什么意思呢？
It means if we criticize them by their on the basis of their birth.
On the basis of their birth. 冒犯奉献者就是我们根据奉献者的出生来批评奉献者。
Yeah, if we say, oh, that person, that devotee, he is very low-class devotee.
我们就说这个奉献者他是一个低阶层的奉献者。
He is born in this kind of back, this kind of family. He has no culture.
他诞生在这样的家庭中，他的出生是没有文化背景。
Or we may criticize them on the basis of some past sinful activity.
或者是我们根据这个奉献者以前所做的罪恶活动来批评他。
Somebody, we may have done something, maybe due to some bad habit. After coming to Krishna consciousness, we may have had some fall down.
我们可能在以前呢有一些恶习、不良的习惯。 也许在 Krishna 知觉加入之后呢，我们可能也有过堕落。
And then after some time again we come back and try to continue Krishna consciousness.
然后再过一段时间呢，我们就又回到 Krishna 知觉当中呢，想要继续进步。
So we may criticize this person. Oh, that person, he did like that. He had that fall down.
我们就可能批评这个奉献者，就批评他说，你看他以前堕落过，他以前就是没有跟奉献者在一起联谊。
So this is offensive.
这就是对这个奉献者的冒犯。
So here you can see Daksha offending, being offensive to Lord Shiva.
那么在这个世界，我们看到 Daksha 他就冒犯主 Shiva.
He thinks this Shiva is not honest.
他说主 Shiva 不诚实。
Just simply because Lord Shiva didn't offer respect to Daksha.
只是由于主 Shiva 没有向 Daksha 顶拜。
Now he did not disrespect Daksha.
主师的并没有不尊重当时。
He was just always worship, he's always absorbed in the thought of the Supreme Lord.
主师的他只是恒常的处在冥想。